that changes color from a very dull gold to a very, very bright, almost white gold. And we're about 5 seconds away from that point now. You may have noticed I'm wearing a few extra layers of clothing. That's just to protect me from the heat. Certainly won't protect me from the gold if I spill it on me and through me and out the other side. We try not to demonstrate that part. Sit there like that for a good 3 hours now until it's cool enough to be picked up with a bare hand. Now we don't have 3 hours to wait. And I am going to pick that up with my bare hands within 30 seconds from now. So I need to give this doll bar another way to cool off. Another way to transfer off some of that heat. I know cold wood cools things down. So by the time I get my gloves off, I should be able to pick this up with my bare hands. Now the best way to test if that is in fact safe enough to be picked up is to use someone else's hand. Or I could feel the temperature of the water. That's my plan B, in case there's no volunteers. Just like that. I'll come right round and show it off to everybody. So the end result is a 3 kilogram bar that is 99.99% pure, 24 karat gold. I have 100 ounces here. The price per ounce at the moment is about $2,200. We're about $71,000 per kilogram. So my 3 kilo bar here currently sits at
congratulated by the Iron Duke, the Duke of Wellington, upon their extraordinary bravery. Whilst stationed here in the Antipodes, Our main role has been the escort of gold from Ballarat to Melbourne Town. However, we also took part in something what you might as insist on referring to as your battle of the Eureka Stockade. Wasn't much of a battle. We woke up early one Sunday morning and we walked right over the top of you. It took us 15 minutes. We were home in time for a hot breakfast. 22 of you never acquired hot breakfasts again. What we're about to do now is fire off a series of shots. I take this opportunity to warn you. These are exceptionally loud. May I therefore suggest that if you have a small child or bubby with you, you make sure that its ears are well and truly covered. For its ears will be a ringing. It will be a crying. And it will be by fault.
What? Order. Up. Head guards. Up. Shoulder. Up. Rubber stand fast. Firing party. One pace forward. March. Squad will prepare to fire in series from the left. Port. Arms. Fingers in your ears.
Don't block your ears, folks.
Somebody cover Axel's ears just in case.
Block them.
I don't know, a little bird told me. Squad, reset. Oh. Number one. Number two. Number three. Order, order, order.
What it does is it pushes the air in front of it out at a high velocity. And by doing that, it will push the bullet out. So, we almost got it loaded. As I said, for the purposes of demonstration, I have to do it slightly differently. And I will put some rodding. A little bit of pushing down the side. And then I need a cap. Now guns progressed from what was a flintlock. This part of the gun was still the same. That part of the gun was very similar to the trigger. A flintlock had a flint here and another one that would come down and make a spark. The spark would then go into an open chamber that had powder in it. The problem with that open chamber that had powder in it is the velocity didn't necessarily all go that way. Some of it came this way. If I was then doing this, and that's why a lot of people with weapons like this had self-inflicted injuries on their face. So to fire the weapon, we place a cap. And it's shaped like a top hat, a gentleman's top hat. So it's called a top hat percussion cap. And it goes on. So the advance here was that's a small hole, it goes down here, and it was less likely to explode in my face. That all depends how many times I'm loading it. A professional soldier could load these three times in a minute. Generally what they did, possibly in a firing line, was they would take the charges from the guy here, out of his back. They would take them out of my back. Person in front would have them on the floor and they would fire in volleys. But I'm a policeman, so I've got a weapon that's more about intimidation. It's more about the noise it's going to make. And we're going to fire it and see if we can make the children jump. Are you ready? Fingers and ears, folks, going to be quite loud.
Musket firing! 3, 2, 1!